Hello, and welcome to Sharon Levy Enterprises. I am Sharon Levy, your purpose midwife. Today's topic is the consequences of comparison. And so we're all familiar with comparisons. I know when we go into the grocery store, we may pick up two apples and we'll look at them and we'll pick the ones that we like, the tomatoes based on our preference. We'll try to find the firm one if that's our preference, or one that's more soft. Whatever our preference is, when we're comparing items, that is what we're trying to identify, which item is closest to what we prefer. And it's not a bad thing in that sense. It allows us to get the item that is closest to what we want, that is going to satisfy our desire at that time. But when we look at comparing ourselves to other people who are in similar situations, who are doing the same things or similar things to what we're doing, the same occupation, married, a mother, then there are negative consequences that comes along with comparison. And so today we're going to talk about four consequences of comparison. The first consequence I would like to talk about is the consequence of self-doubt. Comparison causes self-doubt, and it highlights your own personal insecurities. So when you start comparing yourself to other people, a lot of times you'll look at them and you'll think, oh, well, they do this better than I do it, or they have more followers than I have. And so what starts happening is all your insecurities that you push down, they start to come up and they start to be highlighted. And it goes against your own purpose, because now you start feeling you're not good enough, you're not able to meet the standard that has been set by someone else. And when reality, you're not supposed to meet a standard set by someone else. You're supposed to meet the standard that has been designed for your life. And we know that Jesus is that standard that we meet. We're not meant to be like anyone else. So what the first consequence of comparison is, it causes self-doubt and brings up our insecurities. The second consequence is it breeds jealousy. Comparison breeds jealousy. When we start looking at what someone else has versus what we have, comparing our lifestyles, our social status, our income to someone else, it is easy to become jealous of those people. And then when we become jealous, our actions towards those people change. And with that being said, we start treating people like they're the enemy when they haven't done anything wrong but succeed or attain a goal that we would like to have. So we don't want to compare ourselves to other people because we don't want to become jealous. We don't want to start looking and being envious and thinking about they have something that I don't have, or they're doing it better than I'm doing it. That goes back to those insecurities. So it causes us to be jealous, and then the jealousy causes our actions to change and our attitudes to change towards the people. Again, we can alienate ourselves from people who love us and have our best interests at heart, and who God has put in a position to be of help to us, because we become jealous. Oprah Winfrey once said that you can't, when she, in her position, she couldn't be friends. Her and Gail would not be able to be best friends if Gail wanted her life. So Gail had to be secure in what she was doing and not be jealous of Oprah and the massive success that Oprah has attained. And that is very true. You cannot be friends with someone when you want what they have. You can't be a good friend to someone when you want what they're having. You're jealous of them. So that we have highlights our insecurities, and then it causes jealousy. Our third consequence of comparison is it promotes pride. Sometimes the people you're comparing yourself to, you pick people that you feel are below your standard. So if I'm comparing myself to someone and I say, oh, I'm better than them because I have a degree, I'm better than them, so I should be promoted more because I've raised four children, or I feel like I'm a better wife than they are, I have a better marriage than I have. And so then you set up pride. And when you're dealing with that person, you speak to them from a plateau level that you placed yourself on. And we know that that is not a good thing to do. We should never compare ourselves to make ourselves have a false sense of security, because we are what we consider above someone else. So we don't want to promote pride, and that's a very, very dangerous consequence, because we know a proud spirit shall fall. So we don't want to do that. The fourth consequence, and this is one of the most important consequences, the worst consequence I believe you can have, is it leads to the death of your purpose. Comparison leads to the death of your purpose. When you start comparing yourself to someone else, you are committing purpose suicide. You start off with the self-doubt. When you are doubting yourself constantly and you are insecure and you are bringing all those insecurities up, it is impossible to pursue your purpose with your full heart, because in the back of your mind, the little inner me starts telling you, you're not good enough. Look at this person. They're already doing it. They're better than you. It is purpose suicide. Then also the jealousy. When you are jealous of people, people will sense that in you, and it is not an attractive quality to have. People will start distancing themselves from you because they sense that you have a jealous spirit, and no one wants to be around that. Again, purpose suicide. And then the prideful spirit. Have you ever been around someone and all they do is talk about their accomplishments and all they do is talk about how much money they make and what they just bought and the vacation they just went on, and they're not saying it in a way of, I just want to tell you about it, but their whole conversation is consumed with I. They never ask you about what you're doing. They don't show any interest in you. They just came to hold court and tell you how wonderful their life is. No one likes that person. No one likes that person. Don't be that person that at every gathering, you're just talking about how great you are, how great your husband is, how great your kids are. Yes, it's okay to share that information. And we all know the difference between sharing and then that prideful spirit that wants to make other people feel bad, even if it's not intentionally done. In some ways, it's building up our own prideful spirit. So we don't want to commit purpose suicide. And these consequences we see happening every day on a small level. Theodore Roosevelt was quoted as saying, comparison is the thief of joy. Wow. And it is so true. You will never be fully joyous or happy as long as your happiness is contingent upon the comparisons that you are making with other people for your life, and you're desiring the things that they have. As I'm starting my career and going forth, I used to be a beautician, full-time beautician, and I worked in a shop with the most beautiful and talented ladies. And I always said, there's enough clients for everyone. We all did exceptional work, but all of our work was different. But there was room in the salon for everyone without jealousy, without comparison. You know, we would say, okay, if you like the way they do it better, go let them do it, because that's my sister and I want to see my sister prosper. If you don't want me to do your hair, go let my sister do it, and vice versa. And by that, by being that way or having that attitude within the shop, everyone in the shop was prosperous. Everyone in the shop made enough money or more than enough money. So when you don't compare yourself and you're not going against one another, it is easier to reach your own goals and to pursue your own destiny, because not only are you promoting other people, and as you promote them, you'll automatically be promoted. God is faithful that way. You don't have to tear someone down. You don't have to stand on other people to reach where you're trying to go. That is a myth that, you know, you got to crawl your way to the top and trample over everyone else. Well, then you get to the top and you trample over everyone and it's lonely at the top. And so then what do? You have what you thought you wanted, but now you're miserable. All of this comes back to comparison and the consequences of comparison. This today's topic, I will actually be doing a biblical Bible study on this topic Wednesday, April 10th at Inspired People of Deliverance. And it will come from 1 Samuel 18, and we'll use as the topic, as the subject, David and King Saul and what happened when the comparisons start being made, when King Saul start comparing himself to David. So if you are interested in the biblical aspect and how this affects you spiritually, I invite you to Inspire People of Deliverance Ministry to come and attend our Bible study this Wednesday starting at 7:30 p.m. where we will go into the spiritual side of the consequences of comparison. You do not want to miss it. I promise you it will be powerful. And stay tuned. I may do a live presentation of this Bible study. So please, thank you again for tuning in to Sharon Levy Enterprises. I am Sharon Levy, your purpose midwife. Don't forget to like this video if it has blessed you, and subscribe to my channel, and share this video across your social media platforms. I believe that Sharon Levy Enterprises is transforming the lives of people one video at a time. I can also be reached. I will leave the details in the information section of this video. If you would like to contact me for coaching services, to minister or to motivational speak at your next event. Thank you and have a blessed day.